This is episode 26 of the Just Ask Joey podcast.
And she was like,
who?
And he was like,
ah.
And we was like,
what?
And she was like,
who?
And he was like,
ah.
And we was like,
what?
Just Ask Joey.
Hello, and welcome to episode 26 of the Just Ask Joey podcast. I'm your host, Joey. This is the only place on the internet where a former idiot answers your questions to help you either avoid idiocy or get over your idiocy. And we're hoping for the former. So with the politics heating up, presidential election coming up, we have our nominees. I've been getting a lot of questions about the candidates, about Trump and about Hillary. So today's question is Donald Trump good for America? Now, my answer might surprise you, because my answer is a resounding hell yes. Trump is fantastic for this country. So all your Trump supporters are very excited right now. All your Hillary supporters are like, what the hell is this guy's problem? Here's my explanation. I think anytime you get a candidate that makes people react the way that Trump does, that's a good thing, because politics are really important. I was a political science major at UC San Diego. I love politics. They're obviously extremely important. Who is leading you and who's leading your country all the way down the line? Who's your mayor? Who's your governor? Who's your lieutenant governor? Who's your senator? Who's the president? Those things are extremely important. So anytime you get people fired up about a candidate on either way, whether it's good or bad, whether they love him or hate him, I think that's good for the country, because it's good to get people talking about politics. And the more you're interested in politics, however it draws you in, the better it is for the country, the better it is for those people to actually pay attention to something that's really important. So Trump is fantastic for the country, because he's getting a whole bunch of people that were never interested in politics to be talking about politics nonstop. Like, I don't think I've ever really had a political conversation with my uncle before, and Trump's running, and it's like a whole new thing. You get these people that you never hear him talk about politics, talking about politics again. Now, granted, I don't think he's good for the country. I don't think he'd be good for the country as president, but I think he's fantastic for the country as far as a nominee for the. And I don't think he's great as a nominee for the GOP. I feel bad for them. I don't know what the hell their party's going to do. But the fact that he's pulling people into politics and pulling people into the narrative that would never be pulled in before, I think it's awesome. I think it's great that you get somebody like Bernie Sanders, who's, you know, he's basically the Trump equivalent of, even though he actually knows what he's doing, but he's just as extreme as Trump is to the right. Bernie's just as extreme to the left. And I think when you have those polarizing candidates like Hillary's very polarizing too, but when you have those polarizing candidates, you have an opportunity to have dialogue. I mean, politics has been the main focus for months now, and I don't know if you had another election that's been like that before. Like, it's pretty awesome. I mean, you think about how distracted people are, how many different things they could pay attention to. You think about all the different things on TV, all the different things on Netflix and Amazon and all these different podcasts and different places they can be reading stuff, and people are really paying attention to politics. I think that's a good thing, because it's really important. And whatever side you're on, the fact that you are discussing politics probably more than you ever have in your life, as I think is like a really good thing. And you wouldn't get something like that if Bush were the nominee. You wouldn't get something like that if Kasich were the nominee. And you get that with Trump. And I think that's a really good thing. I also think it's really good that he's somebody like Trump. When you start bringing out dialogue from a group that's usually you don't hear from, you get different insights. And I think that the popularity of Trump is great for America, because it lets everybody else in the country kind of see where the other half of the country really is, politically, socially. When you have a candidate come in and say, hey, we should block all the Muslims from coming in here. Like, if you're on the left, you go, all right, that sounds a little extreme. I don't know if that's such a great idea. And then you have all the people on the right. You're like, no, that'll never pass. Oh, no way. There's no way that'll pass. And then you got this huge number of people on the right side that go, hey, you know what? That's a really good idea. And then it lets you pause and go, oh crap, there's a whole bunch of bigots. That's pretty bad. When you have Trump say stuff like, hey, we're going to build a wall between the United States and Mexico, and we're going to have Mexico pay for it. And you get a bunch of people on one side go, that's like a crazy idea. That will never happen. And then you get a whole bunch of other people that say, wow, you know what? That's a really good idea. It really is like, Trump is like a litmus test for kind of where we are socially and politically in this country. And you wouldn't get this litmus test with somebody that doesn't say crazy ass stuff like he does. And because he's saying crazy ass stuff, and because people are reacting so much, and so just large numbers of people are reacting, you get to really see. So you can really kind of see where the country is, and you realize, oh wow, this country really is kind of 50-50. Depending on what side you're is, Trump, what Trump's saying is crazy, or it's fantastic. What Hillary's saying is crazy, or it's fantastic. But you get to kind of see, like, America's so progressive, or so this, or so that. And then somebody says, hey, we're going to block all the Mexicans from coming in, and we're going to cut off all the Muslims from coming in, and we're going to ship Muslims out, and we're going to do this stuff. And you go, oh, that doesn't sound very progressive. So that's probably not going to pass. And then you see all these people that are supporting it, and you go, oh, okay, so that's like kind of really where we are. You wouldn't get that with a normal candidate. Trump's fantastic for this whole election season. He's great. I think he puts he's a litmus test for, so the Democrats can kind of see where a lot of the Republicans are, where the Republicans can see where a lot of Republicans are, because Republicans always portray themselves as like, you know, business savvy, pick yourself up by your bootstraps, hardworking, intelligent, and the Democrats are like the foo-foo, we're talking crazy talk, and we're talking pipe dreams, and we're talking free college and free healthcare and all this stuff and big government. And then you see, okay, well, Republicans are maybe not the best party because you guys nominated Donald Trump. And then you guys are agreeing with his stance on Muslims and his stance on Mexico and the wall, and you would never get a real picture of what kind of makes up the United States and makes up the political climate and makes up the social climate. You wouldn't get that without somebody like Trump. And for that reason, I think he is amazing for the country. It's never been easier to communicate. It's never been easier to take in as much content of whatever subject as possible. And people are choosing to soak up political content. And I think that's a fantastic thing for the country. It's, to me, it worries me that so many people support Trump. It also worried me that so many people supported Bernie. I think when you're talking about stuff like free college, like, it's impossible. So to talk about it is crazy. To support it's even crazier. A wall between Mexico and the United States is never going to happen. Kicking Muslims out of the country, blocking Muslims from coming in, like completely segregating a group based on their religion, is not going to happen. And what bothers me is that so many people are like, that's what they're rallying around. They're rallying around things that are never going to happen. And does it sound good? Well, I guess depending on what side, I mean, free education sounds fantastic. It's never going to happen. If you're a bigot, building that wall sounds amazing. If you are a bigot, kicking all the Muslims out sounds amazing. But can we just step back and just be realistic for a second? Those things aren't going to happen. And what bothers me is you have so many people that are getting so fired up about so many different subjects during this presidential election, and they're getting fired up over stuff that's impossible. Like, I feel like we're kind of scraping like the bottom of the barrel when it comes to what's getting people fired up. And I think I've mentioned this before. It's like the fifth grader running for president, like class president, and saying, hey, if you elect me president, I'm going to give everybody free ice cream on Fridays. And all the kids go, oh yeah, free ice cream. And all the teachers are like, we're not giving free ice cream, but it's like, well, we're no more homework. If I'm president, we're not going to do any more homework. We're going to get out of school early. And you go, it sounds great. Like, we're a bunch of, like, I feel like we're a bunch of like kindergartners right now getting excited about no homework and free ice cream and getting out of school early when it's never going to happen. Like, when are we going to sit down and look at the facts, look at them with a realistic point of view, not get caught up in the fear mongering, not get caught up in this like America sucks thing, not get caught up in this we're unsafe, not get caught up in the economy sucks, and like all those stuff sounds insane. But that's what people are grasping onto. People are latching onto these things that are never going to happen, that really don't, it's not a realistic impact of it. And I love that we're talking about it. I love that there's so much dialogue about it, but it seems kind of crazy, the stuff that's actually getting discussed as opposed to, you know, maybe some of the more important stuff. So Trump's great for the country. Bernie's great for the country. Get people fired up. Get people talking about it. Get people discussing it. Now the next step is let's be realistic and let's enlighten ourselves as opposed to just being an angry mob talking about stuff that is never going to happen. So if you guys would like to discuss this more, please hit me up in the comments below. I would love to go back and forth. Trump guys, not Trump guys, either way. I love talking about this stuff anyways. Next episode is going to be political, but we're talking about the other side. We're going to talk about Hillary. So if you guys have any more political questions, again, I was a political science major in college, following politics like my whole life. You want to get into the more personal stuff, I've got a couple on hold that are pretty big. If you have something that you're dealing with like right now that you need help with right now, please hit me up on Snapchat or DM me on Twitter and we can go back and forth. That seems to work really, especially Snapchat, seems to work real well with going back and forth, so we can kind of get through whatever issues you're facing right now. If you're enjoying the show, please subscribe to it if you're listening to iTunes. And if you're on YouTube, please subscribe to it also. Leave comments, share the stuff, tell your friends, tell everybody. And the more questions I can get, the more information I can get out there, the more people can be helped. And that's what we're here for, is to me taking my mistakes and my former idiocy and everything I've learned and everything I've gone through to help you deal with your stuff, get over your stuff. Because it's all, everything is, as Maria Forleo says, everything is figure outable. So it's just a matter of figuring it out. Hope you guys have a good day. I'll talk to you soon.
And she was like,
who?
And he was like,
nah.
And we was like,
what?
Just have a go.